Okay, this is going to be one of my last test loads with this early 80s Whirlpool washing machine. This is a really small load of whites. In fact, I'm going to pick the lowest water setting, which is the hand washable. I am going to switch over to hot, and really that's about it. Other than that, it's going to be a pretty basic load. Let me put some soap in. I'm still going to put a nice helping of soap in. I'd like to see some suds or something. Let's see what happens. So I'm going to do an 8-minute wash on this one. So this is going to be full, straight hot water, extra low water level, 8-minute wash. And let's see what happens.
Thank you.
So it's loads like this where you could kind of see what the shortcomings of these older washers are. A modern washer machine probably would have done a slightly better job of getting this. Well, this one's not a good example because this one came pretty clean. Let me see if I can find one that's kind of dirty. Here's one. If this was in a modern, like, LG or something like that, this probably would have came out a little bit cleaner. The problem, maybe the design flaw or the technology that changed, is that the detergents of today are designed to work a little bit longer than what this machine allows it to do. This washer only agitated for about 8 minutes, and some modern washers will agitate for, you know, 20 minutes or whatever. And even though the modern washers, the agitation may not be so vigorous, it gives a lot of time for this newer enzyme-based detergent to go to work, and it actually needs time to work. I imagine that this washer with older, like, phosphate-based detergent would probably do a perfectly adequate job, but, you know, I'm not complaining. This is reasonably clean for my expectations of this washing machine, and I won't need to wash these again. I'm just going to put them in the dryer and be done with it. So this is going to be the last load I do with this washer. I'm pretty satisfied. I'm confident with my repair work on this machine. It's probably run at least a dozen loads so far, and there's no leaks, no weird noises, and all that good stuff. I do hear one of the wigwag, the little, I don't know what you call it. It's the little cylinder that gets actuated by the magnet. Has a little bit of a click to it, but the bushings are there and the plastic is good, and it's just kind of one of those things that, you know, I'm being very nitpicky about it, but it's not anything that's going to be any future problems or anything like that. I would have liked to hear that noise kind of go away, but, you know, you could only grease them so much and you know, do so much to these machines. And you have to understand that this particular washer is almost 40 years old, and for a 40-year-old washing machine, which is past its life expectancy by a factor of double, it's sounds pretty good, honestly. So anyways, that's going to wrap it up with this machine. I'm going to, after this little series, I'm going to get back to my LG front loader. I've really been loathing finishing the series on the machine. It's twofold. This washer, the front loader that I'm doing, is a really good washer, but it has really long wash cycles, and it makes for a challenging film type of thing, because I don't want to put out, you know, 3-hour wash videos or whatever. So anyways, I'll get back onto that, and I got another top loader that I want to test afterwards, and there's plenty of machines that need to be tested, and I'll have a couple of stove restorations coming up in the coming months too, so stay tuned for those. Thanks for watching.